Good morning. Praise the Lord, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Alpha, the Omega, Everlasting Father, Covenant Keeper, the I Am that I Am, the God who is, the God who was, the God who is to come, the mighty man in battle, unchanging changer, our Father, our Creator, our Maker, the God that makes a way where mercy there is no way, the God that does the impossible, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the King of Glory, the Rock of Ages. Praise the Lord, praise the living Jesus, praise the I Am that I Am, praise Him, the God that makes us to have life, the God that gives us our daily bread, the Everlasting Father. Thank you, Father, for your love, for your faithfulness, for your mercy. Thank you for saving our soul. Thank you for sanctifying us, body, soul, and spirit. Thank you for making a way for us. You are merciless, no way. Thank you, Father, for your sweet Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, for the blood of Jesus Christ. I plead the blood on myself, the blood that conquers Satan, the blood that destroyed the works of the devil. I plead that blood on myself, on my family, on my household, on the flocks in my care, on the work of my house. I cover you too with the blood of Jesus. Cover your finances, our finances with the blood of Jesus, our destiny with the blood of Jesus. Praise the Lord. I cover everything that concerns us with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Good morning and welcome to Good Morning Bible Reflections and Prayers. The Lord has asked me to minister healing. Recently, I normally do medical tests yearly. Recently, I went to to my medical test. After doing it, I went for the result, and the doctor gave a report. Some of us, if they say that type of report to us, the fear will just kill us. But like, there's a God in heaven. Whatever the report the doctor have given you, don't be afraid. Amen? There's a God in heaven. I went for the report, I'm saying again, some people get that report, the fear, just the fear, will just destroy them. But there is a God in heaven who heals. So took the report, and the doctor said, they call, asking for further investigations. I said, let us do another test. Let us do another test. So our God intervened. By the time we did the second test, I went to the GP again, and as he was looking at the test, I can see smile, and he said, oh, everything okay. What was high, he said, has gone down to real normal, absolutely normal. There is a God that heals. There is a God that heals. So he has asked me, I didn't plan to do this. I had my own plan to do. He said, minister healing to them. So I'm ministering the power of the God that heals upon you now. If you are watching me from anywhere, or you watch me later, if you are sick, in the name of Jesus, be healed. In the name of Jesus, be healed. For it is written, He sent forth His word, and He healed them all, and delivered them from their destructions. What is that word? For He was wounded for our transgressions, He was bruised for our iniquities, the chastisement of our peace was upon Him, and by His stripes we are healed. In the name of Jesus, by the stripe of Jesus, be healed. There is a 70-year-old woman. You are healed of arthritis instantly when you come in contact with the video. Instantly. There is someone with acute migraine. The healing power of God is coming upon you now. There is someone with pain, left stomach, like appendicitis, how they call it, appendicitis pain. Sharp pain on the left side. In the name of Jesus Christ, that pain is gone in Jesus' name. That pain is gone in Jesus' name. Sharp pain. Spin like this, very sharp pain, is gone in Jesus' name. There's somebody with backbone problem. In the name of Jesus, that backbone problem is healed in Jesus' name. Heal in Jesus' name. Heal in Jesus' name. There is someone that have an issue with the lungs. You are healed now in the name of Jesus Christ. There is someone with acute athlete foot. It's not healing. You have used athlete foot powder. You have used cream. It's not healing. That athlete foot is healed now in the name of Jesus Christ. There is somebody that is having problem with the toes, two toes, the nails, as if they are getting rotten, the nails. And you have tried everything, and that those nails are still just there. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are healed right now. I can see breast cancer healed. Yes, they have diagnosed a woman with a breast cancer. You are healed right now in Jesus' name. You are healed in Jesus' precious name. You are healed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You are healed. You are healed. You are healed. There's somebody with goiter. The goiter is drying up. You are healed in Jesus' name. There's somebody with pus coming from the ear. This ear, this one here. There's somebody with pus coming from that ear. The pores are dried up. You are healed right now in Jesus' name. There's somebody that, as if your eyes, there's sand in your eyes, and it's as if you're going blind gradually, as if there's sand in your eyes. By the authority that is in Jesus' name, you come in contact with this video, you are healed in Jesus' name. There's a healing flood going on. The Lord said, minister deliverance to them. And then in the name of Jesus, minister healing to them. In the name of Jesus, be healed. Anything afflicting you, be healed right now. The healing virtue is coming upon you. Peace is coming. It's coming upon you. Wherever you watch this video from, in the name of Jesus, the healing virtue is coming upon you. My historikele, my kastuya, his name, my kapolista, yenu makisteri na makata, Jesu na marikete, yastetamu kalikele kadiyana, marikele na makapudiyana, yadai na makadiyana. There is a woman, you have another son, and you are moving from one hospital to the other. They can't even diagnose what is wrong with him. In the name of Jesus Christ, that child is healed right now in Jesus' name. Is healed right now in Jesus' name. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. There is a fellow that's going to watch this video. It's going to come in contact with this video. You have a wound. And you think that wound is just going to be healed. And that wound now, 7 years, that wound is still there. It's not be healed. You come in contact with this video by the authority of Jesus' name. That wound is healed. It's healed. It's going to dry up supernaturally. God has touched that wound. And you are going to be healed in Jesus' name. Wow. There is a lady. There is a foul smell coming from your private part. And you are embarrassed by it like a fish smell. Anytime you have an affair with your husband, that thing is putting him off because it's like a fish smell. You don't know how you contacted it. That foul odor, like a fish smell, is going now. It's going. In the name of Jesus, it's going. It's going. You are healed. It's going. In Jesus' name, there is a fellow. You are 26 years of age. You are a man. And you are bedwetting. In the name of Jesus, today the Lord has delivered you. You are healed in Jesus' name. Ooh, there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power. Jesus has power. Whatever the sickness, be healed. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And for all these people you have healed, the person that is having that sharp pain, acute pain, that looks like the people that have pain, appendicitic pain, very sharp pain. I'm not saying it's appendicitic, but that's what I just come, the word I can use, you know. It's sharp pain, acute pain. I thank you because that man is healed. The 26-year-old man with bedwetting, you are healed. The lady of breast cancer, you are healed. I thank you for that lady. Oh, embarrassing something. You say from our female private part, it's smelling like a fish and it's embarrassing to her. It's healed. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father, for all these fellows. They are healed in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. Now, this is what I want you to do. Like most people do when we do the TV one. Immediately you are healed. And immediately they refers to you. We have got people called from Italy, from various parts of the world, when we do these things on the TV. You call to testify, or you go to your church to testify. The Bible says they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And they did not love their lives today. Their testimony is powerful to seal your healing. And because you are healed now, don't go back to sin. Amen? Because sin can destroy. Amen. God bless you. We have done the will of God. That's what God wanted us to do first before we go. I had my own plans. I wanted to talk to you about sounds of abundance of praying before going to the message, because I had a prophetic word from God. There's a sound of abundance of healing. Sound of healing. You know, look at this. That's what God has done. Healing, fruitfulness, sound of abundance of faith, deliverance, sound of blessings coming our way. Amen. That scripture is from the book of 1 Kings 18:41. 1 Kings 18:41. I say, then Elijah said to Ahab, go up, eat and drink, for there is a sound of abundance of rain. That's a prophetic word for somebody. It's a sound of abundance of rain. Be encouraged. Amen. Now we have been doing, in what state will Jesus meet you? We have done part one, part two, and let's go to part three quickly. In what state will Jesus meet you, part three? Amen? We said there are different states possible, different conditions possible when Jesus comes back to the earth. Now, we are saying, in what state will Jesus meet us, you and I? In what state? You know, we are taking our scriptures from the book of Revelation 22:11, and you can read Revelation 26:6-11. The scripture says, he who is unjust, let him be unjust still. No, he who is unjust, let him be unjust still. He who is filthy, let him be filthy still. He who is righteous, let him be righteous still. He who is holy, let him be holy still. We have spoken about the unjust. We have spoken about the filthy yesterday. Now today we want to speak about the righteous. Who are the righteous? That's the three. When Jesus comes, he will meet the righteous. Who are the righteous? The righteous. Who are they? Who are they? The righteous. We are talking about the righteous today. These are the just. The righteous are the just. The righteous are what? The just, the upright. The upright. They are justified by putting their faith in Jesus Christ. Now, it is not your righteousness that makes you righteous, because the Bible says our righteousness is like a filthy rag. It is the righteousness of God that makes us righteous. He said, for he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we may become the righteousness of him in Christ Jesus. That is 1 Corinthians 5:21. So our righteousness is in Christ. So the righteous are the just. Now, the result of when we are justified in Christ or through Christ is righteousness. Take this note. Take note of this. The result of justification is righteousness. Romans 5:16-18. I think I can read that to you, not rushing this, because I have opened up something to you that you should take. Don't forget it. The result of justification is righteousness. And because the result of sanctification, which is holiness, is holiness. The result of justification is righteousness. How do I know? It's in Romans 5:16. Romans 5:16. I read that to you quickly. It says to us that Romans 5:16, and the gift is not like that which came to the one who sinned. For the judgment which came from one offense result in condemnation. But the free gift which are for many offenses result in justification. Now verse 18. Therefore, as through one man's offense, judgment came to all men, results in condemnation, even so through one man's righteous act, the free gift came to all men, resulting in justification of life. So the result of justification is righteousness. So we are righteous because we have put our faith in Christ Jesus. Not because we do one thing this way, we do that this way, we are careful, we don't want to laugh. No. We are righteous because we put our faith in Christ Jesus. Amen? Let's go. You see, righteousness is good. Jesus will meet the righteous. Look at what the Bible says. It says, it's right standing with God through confession. Okay, let me read this. Say, those who have acquired righteousness through confessing, believing, and putting their faith in Jesus, and being found, I'm reading this to you, and being found in him, not having my own righteousness, not having my own righteousness, but what? Not having my own righteousness, which is from the law, But that which is true faith in Christ, the righteousness which is from God by faith, Philippians 3:9. So we are righteous by putting our faith in God through Christ. Amen. 2 Corinthians 5:21, I read to you. 2 Corinthians 5:21, I read to you. It says, you have loved righteousness and hated lawlessness. Therefore, God your God has anointed you with the oil of gladness more than your companions.